The question about what mechanisms, I think, and many of the questions that we are raising here, it will be naive for us to try and respond to all questions in here. And this is why, as Labour, we are thinking around calling for the second National Working People's Convention. There are many sector issues. There are many particular interests. There are many analyses that needs to be made in terms of the journey that we have traveled and in terms of the current environment. So it will not be possible for all these issues to be responded in this room, in my view, or even by ZCTU alone, by ZINASO alone. We need a reflective process and reflect on all these issues. So it is my submission that the citizens facing a heightened crisis should come together and look at all these issues together. The other aspect about whether government has been brought to the table. From Labour, we have a tripartite negotiating forum, which is a platform where we negotiate and discuss and share ideas with government, business, and labour. We've been fighting for that platform for over two decades, and now we got it legislated. But I can tell you, the current mentality of Zimbabwean government is that they don't care about citizens. I've said the government has lost legitimacy. I'm not really much conversant with the political side of legitimacy about how we fight political and attaining power, but that is important. But I'm very much well versed with the input and output legitimacy, whether citizens have voice, we don't have voice. Whether the government responds to citizens' demands. The current government does not respond to citizens' demands. So workers and citizens have got only one option in my view. It is for them to come together, build through civic education, build an active citizenry, and use their agents to demand from the government. Government will respond when workers, citizens, students, churches have united and make clear demands. And finally, it is expected that government will say there's no crisis. The abusers see peace, but the victims won't be able to breathe. They will be telling you, I can't breathe. But the abusers will be seeing peace because they are benefiting. And one thing that is central to this whole debacle about whether there's a crisis or not, they are not just defending political power, and this is why we want all politicians to be aware. They are not defending political power. They are on steroids in terms of primitive accumulation. They are defending economic gains. They are defending their diamonds, their gold claims. They are defending land. They are defending ill-gotten wealth. So they will not end it easily. If you think they are rich, they think they are not yet rich. If you think they are millionaires, they want to be billionaires. If you think they are billionaires, they want their kids to be millionaires. If you think their kids are now billionaires, they want their grandchildren to be billionaires too. So we have no choice. It's a generational call. We need to be persistent. Government is not going to give it on a silver platter. A forward for United Front from us, but we need a united front that is clear, that is based on clear ideological basis, and forward for a second National Working People's Convention.